train a-coming. It's rolling around the bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom.
Hey, there, it's Billy. This week's topic on this tea time is jail. And I was supposed to post on a Wednesday. It's now Saturday. I apologize for that. Sorry, Parker. But I've had a really bad cold and been sick for like fucking 3 weeks now. I'm getting so over it. And I just didn't have the energy to do it. But here I am today. Jail. Jail. Yes, I've given some consideration to this topic, and in anticipation of its arrival, I actually spoke to a guy in Sydney who's a bit more informed on all matters F2M legal health stuff. So my big question to him was which jail would a trans man end up in? And his response initially was that they would probably assess it on a case-by-case basis, so they would look at the kind of crime that you'd committed, whether your sex was legally changed to male, whether you're on hormones, blah, 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 and decide which jail was appropriate to put you in. Then he kind of elaborated a little and suggested that possibly what would happen is that you would end up in something akin to protective custody, which, from my understanding, is a section of a jail where inmates who are at greater risk of physical violence are generally put to keep them, to protect them from the rest of the prison population. Usually in there are some pretty salubrious types, such as pedophiles and serial killers and informants. So it's probably not a great crowd to hang out in, but the other bad thing about it is that you would probably be in solitary confinement, which I think pretty much drives you fucking bonkers after a while. So that's a pretty horrifying option. I think it should be said that no matter what jail you end up in, it's pretty fucking awful. So the first thing I would say is, dudes, don't do anything that's going to end you up in jail, because it puts you at such a high risk of physical and sexual violence, and especially given the female history, etc. It's often not the kind of environment that a trans guy would survive very well in, I imagine. That said, my friend that I spoke to also told me an interesting story about a guy in Australia who was sort of grew up in a pretty came from a pretty kind of criminal background, and you know, he was committing crimes from a young age. When he transitioned, that didn't really stop. But this guy was like 6 foot tall, kind of brick shit house. That's what we call it in Australia. Tall, intimidating, muscular, bearded dude. And he apparently was in and out of female prisons for a lot of his life. So it's quite interesting, because apparently he did quite well in there. I can imagine that a trans guy in a female prison would probably be at a certain physical advantage, possibly, in terms of self-protection, etc., but then be at a greater risk of, you know, discrimination, etc. I mean, it'd be very strange, I think, to be the only man in a female prison. Obviously, I think the big thing when you're considering going into any prison is the risk of rape. And like I said before, I don't think it matters whether you're, you know, male, female, trans, gay or lesbian or straight, or bi or whatever, queer, however you identify. I don't think it matters in terms of being raped, because rape is non-consensual, and so it's just going to be very unpleasant. So, you know, straight men who go into prison and get, you know, anally raped, I think would experience just as much trauma and horror from that as we would. That said, I guess it's true though that trans guys having a particularly often and not all having a particularly a disassociation with often with penetration and with that whole area in general, it can be very disconcerting. I mean, the idea of being raped is in that way is particularly troubling, I suppose. But the other thing that I sort of gave some thought to is I haven't, you know, seen anything on trans guys in jail, but I have actually watched a documentary that's made by an English guy called Louis Theroux. He's great. If any of you haven't seen his stuff, you should check it out. And he makes these kind of interesting documentaries on American subcultures and American life and interesting parts of America. And he went into jail and spent some time in there. And one of the great parts of this doco was him interviewing this couple who were this kind of really good-looking, handsome young guy, and his prison lady, who was a male to female transsexual, and they lived like in a little cell together quite happily, and the whole perspective seemed to be that he was a lucky son of a bitch because he'd scored, you know, the hottest babe in the prison. And you know, they pretty much lived out a sort of domestic relationship within the prison, and they seemed pretty happy and pretty comfortable, and the only issue was that other guys would sort of try and steal her from him. And she, in when she was being interviewed, would say how she liked it being in prison, and when she'd be released, she'd often commit a crime just so she could go back in, because in prison she was like a very desirable quantity, and that the men would, you know, look after her, etc. And that, yeah, I thought that's a really interesting idea. I hadn't really thought about that. I guess trans guys wouldn't experience that same phenomenon because of the fact that we physically look male, and often happen to have, you know, different junk in the trunk, so to speak. So I don't think we'd experience a particularly positive response. But yeah, look, it's kind of a horrifying prospect to me to end up in any prison, so male, female. But yeah, I'd like it'd be great to hear about any people who have actually experienced this and what it meant. I can imagine, you know, just going, you know, just all the little bits and pieces of showering with everyone else naked and, you know, I don't know, sharing a cell and, yeah, I guess there'd be heaps of elements that where your trans status would definitely be like it's an issue. Anyway, I think that's about it for me on this topic. Curious to hear anyone else's thoughts, and I hope everyone's really great out there and doing a lot healthier than me. See ya.